guys, this is Ebony here. Welcome back to my channel. I just want to hop on here really quickly and let you guys know what I do to keep the dry scalp away while I'm wearing my hair straight. Now, one of my previous videos, I mentioned that I would be wearing my hair straight for the month of September, and some of you were like, Ebony, how can you wear your hair straight for so long without it getting itchy and dry and all that? So I decided to make a video because this month I actually had a really good month with dry scalp, and I just want to make a video to tell you guys what I did. So if you want to know what I did to keep the dry scalp away, keep on watching. Now, just to let you know, my hair has been straight now since probably September 1st. Or second, maybe August 31st, honestly, because I straightened it before my friend got married, and her wedding date is September 3rd? I don't know, but anyways, it was right at the beginning of September or right at the very, very end of August. And today is September 28th, and I still have not washed my hair or restraightened or anything like that, and I don't have a huge issue with dandruff at this time, which is very surprising because normally when I wear my hair straight for this long, it starts to, you know, do its own thing. It starts getting itchy and flaky and all kinds of craziness. And I end up having to wash my hair sooner than I want to. But I did things a little bit differently this month just to see how it worked. And I'm glad I did because it worked like a charm. So the things that I did differently is basically instead of using one of my regular shampoos, I decided to use Head & Shoulders. Yes, Head & Shoulders. Head & Shoulders has been around for who knows how long, and it has just been overlooked, at least by me, for like years, because I just always assumed Head & Shoulders not for black people. I thought it was mostly for, you know, people, white people, because they can wash their hair a lot more often than we can, and I just assumed it just wasn't for us, especially because it's got sulfate and all that stuff in there. So it's geared more towards someone who needs to wash their hair more often because they get such dry scalp and flakes, they want to wash them out. That was always my assumption. But I decided to go ahead and try it because it has these elements in it. And I was like, okay, well, this seems a little bit more natural than usual. It has tea tree in it, it has peppermint in it. So I was just like, you know, I could try it out and see how I like it. I mean, it's not a whole bunch of money. And worse than the worst, I don't like it and I use something else. Let me tell you, I'm so glad that I use this shampoo because it has this cooling effect when you put it on your scalp. If you wash your scalp with it and let it sit for a few minutes, you'll know what I'm talking about. Like, it starts to feel like a cool breeze on your scalp, and that feels great after your head's been itching like crazy. Or even if it hasn't, it just feels really good and refreshing. When I wash my hair with the Head & Shoulders, I wash the scalp only because I didn't want to dry out the strands of my hair. I didn't want it to feel like straw, I guess. I was afraid of it feeling too stripped, so I only used it for my scalp. Now, for the rest of my hair, I use Thermal Wonder. I decided to use that since that shampoo is geared towards, you know, natural hair being straightened. I was like, I can't go wrong with that. So I just washed all my strands with the Thermal Wonder and used only the Head & Shoulders at the roots. It paid off so well because I just never had this experience with wearing my hair straight and not having dandruff after all this time. It saved me so much time because I thought that I was gonna have to wash my hair sooner than I wanted to. And as I've said before, this month has been a really busy month for me, so it worked out perfect. Now, the Head & Shoulders did have a little help because I did use another product to make sure that I kept the flakes away, and that is the Mielle Organics Almond Mint Oil. I put that on my scalp probably a day or two after straightening it, maybe even the same night, honestly, but I didn't part my hair in these little tiny parts. You know, I just kind of did one here, did there. Like, I just did it really wide all over my head because I didn't want my hair to feel too greasy or too oily too soon. And I just followed that regimen for about, you know, maybe I did it every 4 to 5 days. And that also having the mint in it, it helped to keep my scalp nice and refreshed and itch-free. It was the perfect match for this situation. So if you are someone who likes to straighten their hair and you want to prolong your straight hair a little bit longer, I would definitely suggest using the Head & Shoulders along with the Mielle Organics Almond Mint Oil. You all know how I feel about her products. I absolutely love them. So it comes as no surprise that that oil helped out with this straight hair situation because I didn't want to have any flakes. Today is the 28th. It's been about, it's going on 4 weeks now, honestly. I think maybe today might be week 4. Yes, time to wash my hair. Unfortunately, Yeah, I don't feel like doing it, of course. But I'm gonna do it on Monday. So until then, it will be fishtails, top buns, and that's about it. That's all anybody gonna get. That's all y'all gonna get from me. So yeah, I hope this video helped you all, and try the head and shoulders. You might like it, you might not, but hey, it's only a few dollars, but I'm pretty sure you'll like it. And yeah, give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already done so. And as always, thanks for watching.